Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, The Legend of Heroes Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We just arrived here in Tonerico, as you can see from the little starting sign, whatever. So we're on the way to Shifool. We can't move. Forest of Deception. I can't seem to move to elsewhere on the map. So I'm guessing Forest of Deception and then Shifool, but I think that's the fourth place we have yet to go. The shrine, the fourth shrine. Notice on the left, I've just noticed it, the Gagharf, which, for those of you who don't know, this is named, I'm not sure, officially or unofficially, the Gagharf Trilogy. What's interesting is that I have not heard, from what I could remember, anyone mentioning the Gagharf, which is basically this huge fissure in the ground, which prevents people from the different continents or regions from being able to get to one another. So anyway, let's look around here. Oh, but it's fine. I can't get it. Harl, the arms dealer. Welcome. You shouldn't really use weapons, even on monsters. What? But there are violent monsters, so I have no choice but to sell them so that people can protect themselves. A reluctant arms dealer. That's interesting. Essentially, it's better if men can live in harmony with nature. Okay. If we go around this way, he'll actually sell us stuff. Let's see if there's anything we can use. Doesn't say anything different, though, unfortunately. Got a master's knife, which I guess Yuri already has. I mean, yeah. So, okay. The hit goes down, but the attack goes way up with a broadsword, a wide double-edged sword. We've got crystal rod for Chris, which is not an improvement. And Morrison already has. Staff of Light, I guess that's what she has. I can get that for Morrison. $1,700. Oh, we have to do the exchange thing. Thank you. Alright, so I'm gonna buy the Staff of Light for Morrison. Wooden bow. The Staff of Light is a staff blessed with light, only effective when wielded by someone pure of heart. Well, let's hope Morrison is one of those. Wooden bow is a bow made of several types of wood, designed for ease of use by women. Small shield, splint mail we have. Hide armor for Yurio. It's technically a little better than splint mail, that's interesting. Fleeting robes. Defense 78. Oh, he's better off with fleeting robes. Okay, so hide armor is an armor made from various hides, sturdy and comfortable. Fleeting robes is made from a slick animal hide, which helps avoid enemy attacks. Oh, yeah. I'd like to get that for almost everyone except Morrison. An emblem cape, bearing the coat of arms of Uldos, sign of an expert spellcaster. Wow. Alright, we need more money. So, Yurio's hit goes down by 5, but it goes up by 20, so I think that's a win right there. Goose could also use it, but who cares about him? So I'm getting that for Yurio. I'm probably gonna finally have to grind for the first time in this game for money. The hide armor. I didn't buy it, right? Or did I? I'll be right back. Alright, so we're switching to the broadsword for Yurio. Split mail. Yeah, we didn't buy the hide yet. Morrison? Oh yeah, he has the fleeting robes. We're gonna give him the Staff of Light. So, his magic attack is 86. Goes up to 95. His attack, 67. Goes up to 75. Nice. So let's sell the Master Knife. A reluctant arms dealer. Who would have thought? Sell the steel sword. Crystal rod. I think at this point it's safe to sell the... the spear. That was Alf's. I mean, you never know. He might join our party again, but... we have two of them, okay. I gotta sell both of them. So... Goose has the hide armor already. Yeah, look at that. Alright, so I want at least one hide armor. Chris goes up too. Actually, well, the fleeting robes are even better. 78. Goes from 70 to 78. Helps with magic defense, and I think that's avoidance. Leading robes, yeah. That's like a magic item. So he has the fleeting robes. Goose has the... yeah. So let's sell this other split mail then. I want to see if he could use the Master's Knife, Goose. Alright, two of them. Oh, he has the Master's Knife. Alright, so we're selling the Master's Knife. Sorry guys, I'm trying to be methodical about this. Yay. Okay. Now, from here, we have that much money, 2637 piers. Technically, could give Goose a broadsword. His attack would go from 97 to 117. I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay. Yeah, 97 to 117. It's pretty good. I mean, it doesn't hit as often, I guess. But that's 2,000. That's almost all the rest of our money. I don't know what we need the bow for, if anything. So we should get the fleeting robes to Chris, actually. Then we could use them for Goose eventually. That's quite an improvement, look at that. Defense 71. Now 79. Magic defense 61, now 71. And what else goes up? Avoidance, yeah, 12. 27. Pretty sweet. So we can sell the other split mail. And I think we should come back here to get some stuff for Goose. I don't know which way is longer. Okay. Thank you very much. Getting kind of broke. Let's see, let me see if we can get one more thing. Can't afford the broadsword. Alright, I'm gonna actually write this down. We just want two things for Goose. Just so I know for later. Alright, so Goose, broadsword, and fleeting robes. So that's all we had left to buy at this point. Nothing else to sell? No split mail or anything like that? We're keeping the books. Let's see if we have duplicates of anything. Resist ring, guard ring. So one of these. So one of the guard rings. Power ring. So one power ring. Okay. Wait, how much money do we have now? Still not enough. Alright, we're done messing around over here. Bernie says, hey, we have travelers. We have had many travelers lately. Just a short while ago, two young men came and decided to stay in our village. Miria also came, arriving after them. Clean air blows into this village from the forests. It's very comfortable here. Why don't you abandon your travels and stay here? You're gonna have to try harder than that to seduce us into living here forever. Hello? Clan the Chapel Master says, the primary use for the chapel spells is for defense. No kidding. They're all healing spells, mostly. It's because we desire a harmonious coexistence with nature that we are allowed to have a store in Tonerico Village. I saw pet food, yeah. Actually kind of, curious to even find anything new. That's all the same stuff. He tried to seduce us into staying into this place forever. Hello? Mayor Laver says, I'm Mayor Laver of Tonerico. Welcome to Tonerico Village. Breathe in the fresh air and recuperate yourselves after your long journey. We have fresh air. It's the only thing we can be proud of in this village. That's pretty sad. I mean, a lot of people take fresh air for granted. Mrs. Capara? When you listen carefully, you can hear various sounds of the forest. They sound just like the singing of winds from Shifool. The sounds of the forest in Udor are very soothing. Okay. Alright, so there we go, Mayor's place. Reluctant arms dealer. Behind the counter, see if he's like, say something else. Kirim says, Hi travelers, how did you know about this village? What did you get here while wandering about in the forest? You look tired. This inn is free. You can use any room you like. We can get some rest here, sure. I'd say we're good at this point. Say anything else from the front? Nope. Okay. The hell was that? Got bats around here or something? Your pet looks hungry. We shall feed thee. Angel food. Yeah, what the hell is that? Gasteru says, Hey travelers! Tonerico Village doesn't have a long history, but it's got a noble origin. This village was built following the advice of the Moonlight Witch. What? Yurio says. The Moonlight Witch? Chris asks. That's right. Around 20 years ago, the Moonlight Witch came here and told us to build a fortune and make it our home. She's fortune? I don't think he said that. But Yurio says, sorry guys. Yurio says, but why did she say you should build a village here? I don't know. Anyway, that's why I call it a noble origin. Build a village and make it our home. Why did I say fortune? Brother. I think I need sleep. Sleep! Hi. Can't see you. Oh, there's Miria, I've mentioned. Hello, this is Tonerico, a village in the forests of Udor. Thank you. Would have never guessed that. Since you are here, breathe in as much fresh air from the forest as you can. It's good for your health. Anka says, Hey travelers! We rarely had travelers before, but lately we've been getting quite a few. We're happy to have people, but we don't want this village to grow too big like a city. We love forests. Then don't make it bigger. Problem solved. Thank you. defense there is different. We haven't been there. I think we've been everywhere else. Oops. Pad says, "Hey, it's you, Yurio. Chris, too. How have you been? Thanks to you, we were able to escape from Foltheon. Have you seen Joy yet? He is watching the forest from the top of the watchtower on the other side." No, I haven't. Alright, let's go there. I didn't even notice a watchtower on this side. Oh, I see. Okay. Have I ever been in this? I think I've been in. Yeah, wasn't I just in here? Yeah. Joy says, "Oh, hi. Yo-Yo and Chris, I wasn't expecting to see you here." "How have you been, Joy?" Chris asks. "You look well. By the way, what are you doing here?" "The arms dealer in Raguna helped us get away. We pretended that we boarded a ship, but we actually traveled west to the mainland and came here. Thank you for helping us back then. Pad and I didn't have to become soldiers thanks to you." "Have you seen Pad yet? He is watching the forest from the top of the watchtower on the other side." Yep, we just were there. Alright, so we're done with this town. Is there another way out? Can't help but think we missed somebody. Much. This is the free inn. I think we've seen everything. Maybe this is just a stopover and we'll continue on this way. Tonerico. Can't even seem to hit that now. Right. That is strange. Figure out where to go next. I don't know how else to leave this town. I'm supposed to go there. I don't see any way to go other than back the way we came. So Tonerico doesn't show up now. Until we get into it. Now we're in Tonerico and I can't go. If I go north, we could go to the Forest of Deception. But I don't even know how to leave the city this way? I mean, it looks like you can open that, doesn't it? I mean, if there's another exit and I missed it, this would be silly, but I don't see anything. No other way out here. So do you agree that the freshest air is here in this village? Yoya says, Mayor, does this village have anything to do with the Moonlight Witch? Yes, we used to be scattered in various parts of the forests in Udor. Around 20 years ago, we built a village and began living here at the request of the Moonlight Witch. It's not much of a connection, but the Moonlight Witch does have a part in the history of this village. Thanks to the forests in Udor. We have fresh air. It's the only thing we can be proud of. Ba-ba-ba. When you listen carefully, you can hear various sounds of the forest. They sound just like the singing of winds from Shifool. The sounds of the forest in Udor are very soothing. That's very nice, but I can't just stay here. I have to go. We don't need a rest. Fine. Nope. What do I do now? See if anyone says anything new, but so far no. Shrug. We're happy to have people, but yeah, about that. Yeah, saw him. Well then, I'm not sure. Can I go this way? No. Is this how it's the Forest of Deception? Maybe we're supposed to go that way. Here we go. Ha. That was kind of a waste to use a finishing move, but... You're in right past Goose. Gonna die anyway. Nice. Poking frenzy deflected. Oh, that one wasn't. Nice. Chris gets to level 18 and learns Paralyze, or 19 rather, and Prayer. Yo-Yo gets to 19 as well. We got a Mind Potion. Let's see what that is. Paralyzes a single enemy. And there was something else. Prayer? Sounds like a buff. It's a skill? Okay. Temporary boost to own healing spell effects. Okay. We could actually go here. I have no idea we can go this way. That was a monster there. Shifool, the capital of Udor. East Wind Valley checkpoint, 725 Milos. Alright, hopefully we can find that broadsword and the fleeting robes in Shifool anyway. Hi. We need money. So we're gonna kill you. Actually, some people need healing. So there's that. He knows healing too, so he'll heal Chris. Missed. Uh-oh. Goose with his 3 hit points. Do you This thing is just buffing themselves. I hope Chris is still gonna go. He needs that healing. I didn't actually realize there was one sitting right there. So one of them is gonna run forward and get this one, as well as Goose. Oh, never mind. It doesn't matter what they do, we're just gonna kill them anyway. But I understand, I buffed myself with everything! Goose, level 20. I don't like how he's a higher level than the rest of us. 66 gold. So now we're in Shifool, just like that. Okay. So I guess that other place, Tonerico, whatever the hell. I guess that was just a little layover to the north. It was north of there, it was Forest of Deception too, but I couldn't find a way out of the town to even go there. Anyway, so thanks so much for watching, guys. Next episode, we'll be exploring Shifool, and always, seek adventure.